I mean, this is professional development in a really practical, hands-on way.
WIT can give you the edge to know how to find your place, how to make a difference, how to connect, how to find resources.
WIT has given me many opportunities on the education front, on the networking front. We've had fantastic speakers and topics.
One of the amazing things about WIT is an all-volunteer organization. So you know every woman coming to that table is not only looking to get something out of it, they're looking to put something into it.
You know, our tagline is from the classroom to the boardroom. We are every place in between.
I think networking in this sense is really understanding where each of us comes from, what are the challenges.
And if you are lucky enough to find your way to WIT, you suddenly have a very powerful network of about 1,000 people.
It gives you those opportunities to really meet people who are in your field.
And I've really enjoyed getting to know all these really dynamic, energetic, exciting women.
One of the best things a woman can do as they're trying to reach their goals professionally is to find a mentor and or organizational support from other women.
Especially just that mentor-protege program is really beneficial for the next generation.
When I was starting out in my career, and even when I was in school, I wish I had had more of a mentor program at that time and had someone to talk to.
So if you are looking for someone who is the coder or the programmer, but now has management experience or is at an executive level, they can pair you up with one of them to talk about their experience and how they got where they are.
I've had several protégés reach out to me later and say, hey, what you recommended worked really well.
And then now we have a program called the Leadership Foundry, which actually prepares senior women executives to serve on corporate boards.
We have everyone from very successful authors and attorneys to young women who have started their own global good organizations.
So it's a year program. There's the two-day intensive training. And then every month there's a networking or special program.
We have now become very close and we'll be an ongoing network for each other, I know, long after the program ends.
And it's very encouraging and nurturing to women who are coming up through the ranks of technology-related organizations.
In this day and age, there's a lot more opportunity for girls in technology. There still needs to be mentoring, there still needs to be advancement, there still needs to be encouragement for them.
Being involved with GIT over the past year with their mentor-protege program was really eye-opening to me.
So getting those girls to think of themselves as future women in technology is happening at a very grassroots level.
I want them to know that there are no limits to what they can do, and there's nothing that should be considered appropriate for them because they're girls or young ladies.
There is such a range of things that women in technology do. You know, how do they get from when they were your age and in high school to where they are now?
Women in technology, I think, is more than just a bunch of technologists. It's actually a community of women, whether it's from a communications perspective, marketing, coding, programming, or even a project manager.
There are many related fields. There is project management, program management, business unit management. There's sales and marketing.
So we find women who join WIT, do some stuff in WIT, may go off and do something else, and they come back to WIT.
This is probably the time in my life when I need WIT the most, especially with the work-life balance.
One thing I found is most women want to design a life for themselves. And so understanding some of the challenges that other women have gone through in terms of designing and building that life can be very helpful.
Challenges for women are far-reaching. You do want to find that balance between being a good mother, being a great worker, and you don't want to sacrifice on either end of the equation.
I think it's incredibly helpful to have those people who can really give you that guidance and kind of talk you through those things and help you understand that, you know, you're not on the boat alone.
Because there are women that have been there and that have done that and have succeeded. They have grown children now. They have maintained their careers. They're in senior level positions. They're on boards of large organizations. And they've had the same struggles.
When one woman helps another woman, amazing things can happen.
And just imagine when 1,000 women help each other. It's Women in Technology.